Well, it's your Auntie Social, and today we're talking about pugs. Dear Auntie Social, I'm thinking about getting a new dog. I really got my heart set on going with a pug. I found a breeder that will have one available next month for only $800, signed Pug Life. P.S. What do you think about this dog? Dear Pug Life, $800? Are you getting a dog or are you getting a used car? You've got to be kidding me, for the love of Pete. Let's see. If you want an inbred, genetic experimental nightmare, then by all means, go right ahead. I can't see anything wrong with getting a mutant animal. You know, their eyes can pop up right out. You know that? Their eyes can pop out of their heads. That is totally not normal. No pet's eyes should pop out of their sockets. And they're breathing. They breathe like an asthmatic fat kid desperately trying to reach for a candy bar hanging right on a string right out of sight of their reach. I don't want any dog that needs a CPAP. Well, at least a CPAP will keep their eyes in place, so I guess that's a plus. I say instead of spending hundreds to thousands of dollars on a dog, just go to a nursing home. Find the most battered, debilitated, drooling senior that you can prop up and take it home with you. It would be cheaper alternative than that. They both probably cost the same in doctor bills and both probably gonna piss all over your house. They both probably have breathing problems, bug eyes, and miss the toilet. If you want to clean up shit all day, do that instead. I've got a friend that has a pug that isn't even 2 years old and it needs a hip replacement. That's like saying you have to give your teenager a hip replacement. It makes no sense. If these dogs were human, they'd be the equivalent to Sloth from the Goonies. Only you can't give him a chocolate bar to appease him. I'm not sure what makes me more disgusted. People who spend tons of money on the mutant pug dogs or the people who spend bundles on designer dogs like the Labradoodle. That's not even a thing. Even the guy who created the Labradoodle says he wished he'd never bred them. They're nightmares. You just spent a few hundred dollars for a developmentally challenged mutt. I'm not joking. He himself calls them Frankenstein's monsters. He says that they're either crazy or they have hereditary problems. So if you just have to have a pug, go right ahead and get yourself a genetic mutant dog and enjoy the vet bills. Or go to the pound and keep a dog from dying. It's your choice. If you have a question that you'd like to Auntie Social to answer, send them to me at ourantisocial@gmail.com. Well, that's Auntie Social. If you like what you saw, subscribe. Come back and see me again.